know, that he was kind of building something great here. So we decided, hey, we'll put it on What to Go Next. I'm your host, Ian Jindra. We like to get ahead of things. We like to, you know, find this sort of niche thing and then, you know, just bring it to life. So let's see. So we're doing a single player, and we're going to explore the storyline. Obviously, it's just seeing these things, and maybe especially when I'm reviewing something, I'm going to test it at the same time, which is what I tend to do. I'm fairly sure that this has a free demo or something similar, so I'll put a link in the description below, and that way you guys can play along. It looks awesome. They have this really great app onto it, so we were super stoked to check it out. I love the bunny. I love the concept that we're living in a world that's gone to decay. So two thumbs up so far on that. This is a completely new studio, so if you've never heard of it before, I'll be sure to, you know, put all the links around there and everything like that, and reviews for you guys, and make sure that you have, you know, free stuff to keep you from going crazy when we're stuck inside this much. Coffee is $1, so. That's all. Twitter, Facebook, VK, everything is down there. So if you ever want to talk to us, we are here. 2081 Western Europe. Oh, cool. So we're in Europe as well. It's always an interesting setting because it's so old. It's impossible to go there and not understand that civilization was built there for a lot of Western culture. It has things like low walls, etc. Okay, this is me. Evening, everyone. Latest reports tell me the crusher board is coming through Terra Nova from the southeast all the way to northwestern. We need support. Okay, so we're receiving some sort of radio transmission from the bandit. Yeah, so the graphics were this weird mix of, like, cyber otherworldly. It really does speak to, if you read female YA at all, there's this abandoned carnival theme to it that really just vibes with our crowd. Hunter, the signal picked up is getting stronger. A source must be around here somewhere. I guess I gotta take out these pressures first. Like, I could have told you there was a good-looking brunette guy coming up. Welcome. Look around with QRE, middle mouse button. Move the camera to WASD. So what I'm going to do is try and take these out with the turn-based style of combat. Look around with PA. Okay, so I can rotate my camera. I've got two of these guys, not much to hide behind. And then I can move forward and backward. So we're going to head for here. And do setup. This is your hand. Use cards in your hand to attack or defend yourself. Alright, so let's move closer. Right click the indicated paths to move there. Okay, so basically instead of using a 1-2-3 box, what they did was an enemy just woke up and moved into its like a range. They're using like card shell attacks. That's really popular with cartoons right now, so I might get dealt in more cards as I go. Just double the chance of that. So some basic combat animations here. Three of card shine. Manage to dodge all. So let's manage here. Fully attack to both of them. One person's done. That's what I'm at. We're gonna melee, obviously. Next one, I get back to that. Right click again. Power up, get some cover, etc. Now I have 5 of them. I'm gonna use one. Obviously, I wanna have guess we're going to be exploring the fucking story. I don't want to get mad though. Should I get the I mean, obviously, they're, you know, their terminology is spot on here. So, we are going to continue to move around here. Walk to the next one. So, all that I have to do is actually touch it to interact. Improve range attack. Cover up to two. Let's try this one. We'll use the slug. I do have another target here. Well, I might have been able to recover my money. You know, that had not occurred to me. Alright, so we're kind of tired here, but we're gonna try and just get it. That's all I'm hanging out here. So let's close. Like strategy, this is the hexagonal is set up in a turn-based way that I last saw in Great Blue. That was a much wider strategy game. That's a lot more like the original World of Warcraft, because this has a lot of story backing it. So it's a little bit more of a grind, like the old Crusader No Remorse and that sort of thing. The card turn-based isn't all that different from aiming a pistol. A little bit more involved is because you have a collection then. So it doesn't all go through the month anymore. People who've gotten used to the polygonals. And some people just didn't want the drafts anymore. Ghost Crusher's just sitting, you know. Look here. I guess I like to keep my enemies close for you. I'm only following your signal. I'm not even friends here. Don't get me wrong, I'm thankfully got rid of them. Those are teeth. You want to lick the stronger ones. I could have. I have this walk. Made that yourself, I get where you're not scared. I'm a bit worried though. I know what you're doing. Trust me. Got our share of leaders. Well, it's gonna look like a little bit. Why did you say we are the other survivors? My daughter went away to me and she said, she's taking me home. I'm gonna go look for her. It's chance for not finding me in the ground. I'll warn you about that. really confining. Open a hideout. You can pick your deck, etc. Okay, cool. So I get a home base. I get to look around and kind of set up. And then I have my first mission where I go out into the woods and I find the river daughter. So I am in gender. This is what to play next. Link in the description below. Check it out. It's an awesome dub. Interesting interface. Definitely different direction, but really detailed. Extraordinarily well done. Polished skill set. So I would keep an eye on it, especially if you're in the gaming community. So you can support it below. Or like I said, you can buy some cup of coffee. That's $1. Or liking and subscribing, commenting is always totally free. Welcome, guys. So smash that subscribe button.